With no sign of a search team, it's time to find Cody.
I don't want to haul that 20-pound battery around with me in the desert. So in a situation like this, you've got to have a contingency plan to make another fire.
I need to work on some char cloth over here.
Char cloth is a piece of fabric that's burned without oxygen, so it remains highly combustible.
I have a piece of cotton material here that I pulled out of the back of this Volkswagen. This is more than enough for a couple different fires. So now all I really need to do here is get all the oxygen closed off from this piece of cloth inside here. And I can just set this right in these hot coals, just like this. Put this flat rock over it. The only thing I want to escape out of this now is gas.
And what you have to do is basically superheat this without letting it catch fire. And basically it carbonizes and becomes char cloth. And it will take a spark very easily that way.
When charred correctly, the cloth will ignite with even the weakest of sparks.
If you know how to improvise and adapt to the situation, and you can take a car and get everything you need off of it to keep you alive as best as possible. You know, even the little things like this. We've got this headlight, and now I've got a parabolic lens here that I can use to start a fire. I've also got a container here I can use to cook in because it's metal, or I can drink out of as a cup. When I think about stuff I'm gonna carry, if I can't think of at least three uses for this, I'm not taking it with me. It's too much weight for what it's worth.
You know, I have general fatigue, but I'm feeling a lot better than I did yesterday. I think whatever that was moved through me, thank God. I have some downtime while I wait for Dave, but I'm gonna make use of that time. I need to make some sandals. The last time I wore shoes, 22 years ago? Last time I wore sandals, probably within the last year. No, I don't care for wearing shoes, and there's multiple reasons why I go barefoot. And one of the reasons is it puts me in closer contact with Earth, forces me to slow down, so I pay attention to more stuff. It makes sense to me in my line of work with what I do. I try to live what I do, not just do what I do.
Scientific studies have shown that people did have healthier feet before shoes were invented. But over 2,000 years of shoe wearing have left human feet vulnerable to the harshest elements.
A lot of people's made Tyre sandals, the Tarahumara, northern Mexico, that's a lot of people's that, because they were resource poor, used the rubber off spent tires to make shoes. This is the seat belt from our auto. So I'm cutting this to make straps for my sandals. So it's a pretty efficient, simple way to turn these tires into some footwear that's very low tech. But there's the finished product, so I think that'll work. There's a pretty nice piece of cactus up here to tie this bandana onto. Visibility, contrast, and movement are hallmarks of signaling for rescue. I do not want him walking past me. Dave and I agreed on about every 15 minutes I would come out and flash the horizon. This might seem like an innocent little piece of car mirror, but this sucker's very potent from a distance. I'll just hold it back, and wherever I want it to be will be with the crotch of my fingers here, and know that a bit of that flash is going through my target area here, and I'll just hit it up on the horizon. And I need to pop in and get some shade.
Cody should be flashing me. I should be seeing Cody's flashes by now. I'm getting up on some high ground now. We split up and we should have never done that. That's never do that in a survival situation.
That's gotta be him.
Come on, baby. Give me a signal.
Ain't no other reflective source like that out here. I know a signal mirror. There. He's probably about a half mile out or so.
Oh, yeah. There he is. Cody! Cody!
I would cry when Dave came, but it would waste water. He'll just have to read the emotion in my feelings.
Hola.
Hola.
Buenos dias, amigo. Es casa la Cody?
Si. There's not a lot of shade up here, but try to get some.
¿Dónde está agua? You got some water, brother?
A little bit here. when someone has to separate in a survival situation and they actually make it back together, it's an amazing feeling, you know, because it's a lot easier to try to do any sort of survival work in a pair than alone.
Is that all the water you got?
That's what I got. You can't get blood from a stone.
You know, Cody's a desert survival expert, and even he couldn't find water. So for someone with inexperience in desert environments that can't find water, they're buzzard meat.
The area may be a brutal desert, but it's at the bottom of a valley. Descending into it is the best bet, where runoff is more likely to collect.
Nice Jerusalem cruisers, man. When'd you make those?
I made them this morning. They should work.
Nice. Was that to keep your feet from getting stuck?
Yeah. Ready?
All right, man. I'm ready.
Lead on, oh wise desert rat.
I gotta take a pee.
Yeah, me too. You know what I say about this, man? I say the desert. That's what I'm saying to you.
What color is your pee?
Well, I can't tell because there ain't enough of it coming out.
Producing less than a liter of urine a day is a clear sign of dehydration.
Yeah, urine is the number one indicator I use in the desert. If your urine has any color to it whatsoever, it's your body's way of saying you need more water. So ultimately, I want my pee looking like the water I just drank. Mine's straw colored. Well, I didn't suppose it would be clear for either one of us, but you good?
Damn, son.
You know, what I have noticed is it does seem to be a little bit greener here. So that's a good sign, but it doesn't mean there's anything for us to procure as a human being. It's pretty to look at, whoopee-doo.
Hey, man, I'm hearing something. Can you hear that?
Yeah, there's rocks coming down over there.
No. I hear something different than the rock. Hey, man, that's getting louder. You hearing that, Cody? Hey, man! Look at this, man, look!
I'll be damned.
Look at that, I wish I had like a 400-foot straw right now.
You know, Dave, in my country, this is just almost unheard of. I've been in a lot of situations where I've been low and short on water. I've been very, very thirsty and dehydrated. And what it's like to take water and put it up to your lips, it's almost... It's a pretty intense experience.
An active person can stay hydrated on less than a gallon of water a day. But the average American uses nearly 100, most of it, to flush the toilet.
My country, it's dry. I compost my own waste. I catch rain. I try to use water two or three times, and I see wasted by my culture. And so when I see something like this, you realize what's truly needed for life, and all the drops away.